Again, once more, fellow students, we are welcome back again into our lectures. This is Enchelon, I'm a history teacher in Douala. So, wherever you are welcome again into the second segment of the lectures. We have looked at the political causes to population movement in the 19th century Cameroon. And as I earlier said, we have political causes, we have geographical, we have economic, and we have socials, and then we are going to look at the ramifications or the repercussions or impact or consequences of population movement, which will be divided into positive and negative impact. So we are going to look at the geographical causes of population movement in the 19th century Cameroon, and the formula we call it quit for the day. And then next time when we meet in, we are going to look at the economic causes, look at the social causes, and then look at the consequences of the topic, and then now we look at now questions and how you can interpret and answer those questions. Okay, we are going to be demystifying on the geographical causes to population movement, because migration of people in the 19th century Cameroon was not only caused by political causes. If you look at GCC 2020, you discover that this was the question number one was the extent to which geography was responsible for the migration of tribal groups in the 19th century Cameroon, which means if you are a student tackling that question, you are going to take geographical causes to population movement and form your MP1, main part one, then other causes now form your MP2. So our first geographical reason why people were moving in the 19th century Cameroon, we should be talking about climate. Climate played a greater role in the displacement of people in the 19th century Cameroon, because a mild climate was a pull to people. A climate which was favorable to their settlement, which we call a mine, was a pull to their settlement. While a harsh climate scares people to move away to different settlements where the field was not comfortable. So people were moving because they needed good climate. And we have cases in points where people migrated because they needed climate. We talk about the chambers. The chambers. When we talk about the chambers, we are talking about the valleys. The migration from the northern part of Cameroon, from Lake Chad, towards the western, towards the west, and later to the grass field, was because of climate. The valley chambers have initially settled in the Lake Chad basin in the northern part of Cameroon, and they're mostly involved in agriculture. At one moment, there was a 4 year long drought or dryness, which caused them now to migrate from the Chad towards the western or the grass field of Cameroon. Again, aside the chambers, we also have the migration of the tikas from the northern part of Cameroon to the grass field, was also as a result of harsh climate. So those are some glaring examples on that climate that causes people to migrate in the 19th century Cameroon. Now, our second geographical factor we should be talking about, mountains. Mountains also first led to the migration of people. People migrated mostly towards mountain summit, to the top of the mountain, because they were escaping from their aggressive neighbors. They feared that on the top of the mountain, if an enemy is coming, they could easily see the enemy coming since they were up. And because of that, they could attack the enemy and defeat the enemies. Others also migrated to the mountain summit because they knew that at the top of the mountain, they were in mild climate and they have to move towards the mountain summit. We have cases in points. We have that migrated towards mountain summit. We have the Bakwere migrating towards the slopes of Cameroon because they needed a good climate and fertility on the mountain. Also, we also have the Fulanese who moved towards the Mandara Mountain in northern Cameroon because they needed the climate of the mountains. Again, the next point we talk about rivers. The next geographical point is river. river or water bodies, as we know, they are very important, and they were very important to the people in the 19th century Cameroon, because they needed water from these rivers for domestic purposes. They needed water to do laundry. They needed water for cooking. They even needed fish from the water. They needed sand. And because of that, people were migrating following river courses, as they followed the course of the river, and when they discovered that along the banks of the river, it was fertile, they now have to settle beside the river. We can talk about the case of the example. We have the Bamli case, and the Bamuns. They have settled towards River Mbam in the west region. We also have another example where the Fan and the Beti in central region, the Fan and the Beti, they also settled towards river or beside river Sanaga. And we can also talk about the Dwalas who migrated and settled in the Wuri estuary following the course of the river Wuri. Those were some examples of tribes that migrated because of rivers. Again, we have the geographical factor, which we talk about the role of lakes. Lakes were also water bodies, and being water bodies, people needed to go beside the water, since water is a source of life for different purposes, for building, for domestic purposes. People have to migrate towards lakes for settlement. And because of that, we have to look at the Bakosi and Basosi moving towards the Twin Lake Upema Nemuba to settle there, because they needed the lake for their different purposes, domestic purposes. Bakosi and Basosi moving towards Lake Upema Nemuba. Again, we can also talk about the Muslim Fulanis who migrated, the Muslim Fulanis who migrated towards Lake Chad, because they needed also the lake for their own domestic as well as for their grazing of their animals. The last geographical we will be looking at, talk about search for grazing land. This factor also led to the migration of people in the 19th century Cameroon. This was a factor that orchestrated or caused the movement of the Fulanis from northern Cameroon to the grass field, because they needed pasture or green grass for their cattle to feed on. Since the northern part of Cameroon was being suffered or was facing the extension of the Sahara Desert, the Fulanis now started having a shortage of pasture for their cattle to feed on. And because of that, they were now migrating to the grass field to settle. That's why when you go to the grass field in the northwest, you can see the Muslim Fulani, you see them in Kambe, you see them in other part of northern part of Cameroon, or the northwest, or the grass field, because they have to migrate to look for grazing land where their pastures will fit on them. So these are some of the geographical factors that led to the migration of tribal groups in the 19th century Cameroon with their examples. Now we will be looking at next time when we meet, we'll be working on the economic causes of population movement. We'll look at social causes. Then we'll look at the impact of population movement in the 19th century, both positive and negative impact. And then now we look at some questions, that they ask. But as I earlier said, in 2020, the GCA board set a question to the extent to which geography was responsible for the migration of tribal groups in the 19th century Cameroon. When they talk about geography, definitely they are talking about geographical factors. So MP1 of the question that came in 2020, we talk about geographical factor to the migration of tribal groups, which means that out of the geographical, you can take four and then form your MP1. Four factors were explained with examples, which means that at least a factor you explain with example can fetch you 3 marks. If you take 4 times 3, can give you 12 marks. Now, the second part of the question, which is MP2, you bring in other factors that contributed to population movement. And when we're talking about these other factors, let us not only go and dwell in one area or dwell the 4 other factors that are coming as MP2, you go and overwrite on that economy because you are overmaster it. No, it's not supposed to be like that. If you are writing MP2 other factors, you can take 2 political courses. You explain and expand way with example. You take 1 economic. Then you take 1 social to balance up your work so that the examiner should be able to know that the population movement or the migration of tribes in Cameroon in the 19th century was caused by a variety of factors. So that is how it's supposed to be. But when we run up the topic, we are going to enter into more questions. As I am, we'll be going ahead. If you are having some challenges in history, Paper 1, Paper 2, and Paper 3, you should contact me. As I said, I am a history teacher and I'm based in Douala. You can contact me for extra classes because I'm doing extra classes in College Progressive Ngonu in Bonaberry. So you contact me. I'm going to give my number. You can contact me on WhatsApp or you contact me through a normal call. Then we can discuss. But that notwithstanding, we will continue to work through this meeting. The days will be when we will continue to work with us. But if you need further information, you can contact me through my number 679-26-30-27. That is my number. You can call me. Call me Sir Angelo. Sir Angelo. That is me. Thank you so much for following the lectures. As I said, if anything you are not understanding, you get to me, then clarify it out. Thank you so much.